A&M, a team with plenty of veterans. They return all five starters from last season, had a very good year in their last year in the MEAC. Now in the SWAC this year, from one HBCU conference to another. And there's a deep two drilled by DJ Jones, a graduate student out of Baton Rouge, former Tulane player, and at FAMU for a little while now. So they've got the lead, pulling on the pull-up, and gets the friendly bounce, and UC Riverside takes the lead back. Meringue steps in, and the rebound pulled down by Dominic Pickett. Returned to the starting lineup on Monday against UTEP, and has put together back-to-back double-digit scoring efforts. Cameron, can he hit another? Hit too strong. And now in transition, here's Jalen Spear on a pull-up triple. And well off the mark, Flynn Cameron. End-to-end we go. Cameron's going to slow the pace here.
Just going to say, slow the pace. Get into your offense.
Now, UC Riverside trying to improve on its shooting here. Under 42% at the start of the season. Ninth out of 11 teams in the Big West. Their defense has been good. Their threes have been pretty good, too, though, to pick up the slack. Here's Mormon battling with Meringue. Lost the handle. Kick out Pickett with a shot clock winding down. It's an air ball. And we'll give it back to FAMU when we return. 5-4 lead for UC Riverside here in the Black Friday. Riverside here hosting Florida A&M, the Rattlers and the Highlanders here on a Black Friday afternoon. Daniel Madding checking in for UC Riverside along with Will Tattersall as Mike Magpio has gone to his bench here early on. Both teams, Steven Douglas, settling for a lot of jump shots, and they haven't fallen just yet.
Tough defense on both ends.
There's a pull-up jumper right on cue. Cameron Reeves knocks one down with a swish. He's a multi-year starter as the point guard for FAMU. And head coach Robert McCollum says Reeves knows the playbook like the coaches know it.
Important to have a general out there on the floor for your team.
Pullen creates space and drills the triple. Now UC Riverside, percentage-wise, not a runaway when it comes to three-point shooting, but they knocked down a lot of them, 8 per game, second best in the Big West, and they've already got 2 here early on.
It's an important part of their offense.
Reeves trying to answer off the back of the iron. Tattersall in there. It's knocked along the baseline, a last touch by UCR. A fresh 20 on the shot clock here for Florida A&M, who has also rotated in legend Stamps. He's a Southern California native from Rancho Cucamonga. Went to Etowah High School, always a very good prep basketball program. His team in 2019 reached the state Division I semifinals and eventually lose to another very good prep program down in this area, Chino Hills. McCray back in the ball game. Saw Martinez come in for him. Quick change back to the original starting center. Pulling off balance. Karam's off and Stamps the rebound. Meringue dishes it off. Reeves. And there's a big rebound inside for Daniel Madding.
Madding with a double-double in the last home game here at Riverside.
And this one turned over as Pullen stepped along the sideline upon receiving the pass. Pullen got a check out, and Dominic Pickett will come back in. And for FAMU, Keith Little's on the floor for the first time. And also for FAMU, we're going to see DJ Jones come in for Meringue, and Quentin Ford going to come on for the first time for the Highlanders. 12:46 to go in this first half. Both teams with 3 buckets. UCR with a couple 3-pointers here early as the defense has been good on both ends. Fallaway jumper is short there from Jalen Spear. And we got a foul on the rebound. It's going to keep it here with FAMU. Adding picking up the foul, battling for the rebound. Errant pass, and it's going to be a foul on Dominic Pickett. It's like in football when you see an underthrown ball and the receiver come back there, and Pickett not quite sure where the ball was, so he gets whistled for the foul, not making an effort to grab it along with Jalen Spear.
Just kind of wrong place, wrong time right there. Picks up the early foul.
Here's MJ Randolph still trying to get going. Littles. Well, FAMU now 3 of 15 from the floor to start. And Randolph still being held scoreless at 0 for 3 from the floor. And he's a guy that scores about 19 per game. Pickett, tough shot and gets it to fall. A little bit of contact, but able to get it to go. And in transition, Stamps a little too strong off the glass. Great feed there from MJ Randolph. Stamps couldn't finish.
Yeah, Randolph would love to see Stamps finish that one. The play before, though, you got to love the cut ability for Dominic Pickett.
Pickett, and a bad pass. Be a timeout on the floor. UC Riverside leading 10-6 here on Black Friday. And Steven, as we check things out here early on, lots of jump shots. We haven't had a free throw attempt just yet as a result of all that. But both teams pride themselves on defense, and that's what we've gotten here in the first 8-plus minutes.
Yeah, defense is showing up strong here early. And we'll see if some dribble penetration from either team can result in anybody getting to that free throw line here in the first set.
Here's Keith Littles looking to Randolph, who has his first points of the ball game. MJ Randolph, preseason All-Southwestern Athletic Conference selection. He had 27 in their opener against Kansas State. A very impressive performance there in a losing effort.
It was very impressive, especially considering that Kansas State was double-teaming Randolph most of that game.
There's Callum McCray. His first points of the game on Monday against UTEP. McCray became the 11th New Zealand native to score 600 career points at the Division I level.
And you'd like to see him get started early for the Highlanders offense.
He already has 5 rebounds here, and we're not even at the midway point of this first half. Spear bouncing around and down. Back-to-back buckets for FAMU. Keep this a 2-point ball game.
Shooters roll.
Cross court, Tattersall.
Nice.
Drills it. Now a 3-point ball falling here early on for UC Riverside. And Tattersall, after he started for a little while without Dominic Pickett available, he's coming back off the bench. And I'm sure UC Riverside and Mike Magpio love having his shooting coming off the bench.
Yeah, pretty good guy to be coming off the bench for you. Good look by the big man, Colin McCray there as well.
Spear was calling for the screen, didn't get it. McCray with another rebound underneath. J.P. Mormon back in the ball game, taking it across the timeline. Here's Ford. And too strong there, not much separation as Jalen Spear stuck with him step for step. Randolph. McCray now with 7 rebounds inside. The big fella just collecting all these missed jump shots.
What a luxury for Coach Mike Magpio. Zion Poland, Dominic Pickett, so many guys can bring the ball up the court for you.
UC Riverside taking a quick 30-second timeout here. Going to rotate some guys in. So we'll stick right here as Florida A&M coming all the way over to the West Coast here. They joined the SWAC this year along with their rival Bethune-Cookman, formerly in the MEAC for a while with a slew of other HBCUs. So why the move going from a conference dominated by HBCUs to another? Oh, geographically definitely fits a little more with Florida A&M. As we're going to take a look at our keys to the game here.
Perimeter
and
defense.
What are you looking for, Steven?
Keep that defense going for the Highlanders. Great showing against UTEP. Keep the perimeter defense and keep guys like MJ Randolph from getting it going early. Both teams need to take care of the ball.
I mentioned limiting turnovers there. 5 for UC Riverside, but 0 for Florida A&M. And the Rattlers trying to get Randolph going here. 2 points on 1-of-5 shooting early on. Cameron lost the handle, able to get it out to Pullen. Pickett.
Run it down.
There's Mormon. And Cameron's going to pick up a loose ball foul here. Cameron Reeves, great hops to go up and get that rebound. Well, Florida A&M, they have 10 points. I got it wrong here on the live stats, but they've had someone different score every basket so far.
Yes.
5 players with 2.
Yeah, absolutely. Spread it around. You definitely look for MJ Randolph to kind of take over at some point here.
DJ Jones. Jalon Martinez gets in there to deflect it away. Now UC Riverside scoring about 67 points per game. towards the bottom of the Big West. At their defense, number two in the conference at this point. Great rotation, and Cameron finds Jaylon Martinez underneath.
Cameron taking it in. Looked like he had a chance for a layup, and then noticed the big fella standing by himself. Feed the big guys.
Even though it hasn't been a flurry of offense here early on in the season for UC Riverside, they've done well to assist the basketball. Good ball movement so far. Opened up a 17-10 lead here inside 8 minutes to go in the first half. There's that ball movement again. Mormon just rims out on him. Littles, acrobatic shot, and the follow-up flush, DJ Jones. Coming off a game last weekend against Miami when he had a career-high 24 points, and the 6'9 graduate from Baton Rouge with a big slam there to get Florida A&M back within five. And Randolph gets his hand in there. Cameron trying to recover, and he'll collect it. And they'll reset the shot clock here. Randolph is still lying on the other end of the floor, and there's a triple nailed down by J.P. Mormon, and now Randolph going to get back up, and he is holding his left wrist. So that'll take us to a timeout on the floor. Hopefully M.J. Randolph's okay as we step aside. 20-12, UCR on top of SRC Arena. It's the final game of the Cerebro Sports Golden Turkey Classic. Little round robin between UC Riverside, Florida A&M, and UTEP. The Highlanders defeating the Miners on Monday. UTEP defeating Florida A&M on Wednesday. And now the Rattlers making the trip further west here to try and get a win on the week. UC Riverside trying to go 2-0.
Where's the turkey?
I don't know. Want some?
Yeah, some golden turkey. Sounds good.
Must be a special kind of turkey. So they're no longer looking at the hand of MJ Randolph. He is sitting on the bench, so we'll see if he's able to come back in here momentarily. He took a dive for a ball and then kept himself on the deck before they called time out there. There's a three in the corner left short from Spear. And an acrobatic rebound in the corner from Zion Pullen. So pretty diverse scoring here so far from UC Riverside. Seven different scores as Pullen lays it in. And it's Zion leading the way, 7 points. And UC Riverside now up by 10. Little 10-2 run for the Highlanders here. Marang left his feet, but had some help there from Spear. A reset here for FAMU. Reeves, a little bit of space. That was a long two that caromed off. Pullen wants to attack, lost the handle. That's going to go for a kick ball against Pullen and give it back to the Rattlers. You'll see throughout this game, you'll notice a bit of a different logo on the uniforms for Florida A&M, as we do see MJ Randolph is going to come back in. They've got LeBron James logo on their jerseys, the first athletic program in the country to have LeBron's logo on their uniforms. We, of course, see Air Jordan on a few schools around the country. So FAMU teaming up with LeBron, and they're very excited about merging with LeBron. They're already a Nike school. Here's Pullen in the lane, and he's having a nice first half here. 9 points on 4 of 6 shooting, and that's going to prompt a timeout from Robert McCullum here. And just a quick reset. He wants to make a change and get legend stamps in the game. Just a 30-second timeout here. Talk about Florida A&M a little bit as you get one more look at that three from J.P. Moorman moments ago. 4 3-pointers for UC Riverside here at the start. And Robert McCullum, the fifth-year head coach at Florida A&M, just signed a contract extension in June, was the MEAC Coach of the Year last year, first FAMU coach to win a Conference Coach of the Year honor. Bit of an early exit, though, in the MEAC tournament. They had high hopes. They thought they could win their conference tournament. And now coming over to the SWAC, things probably going to get a little more difficult for them, projected to finish in the middle of the pack. But they still like their chances with all the experience, all five starters coming back from last year's team.
Yeah, a lot of experience, a lot of scorers coming back from last year's team. Highlanders been good on the defense, and they've just been daring Marang to take those jump shots. He's 1 for 6.
And here's Randolph, just 2 points so far, and forced to give it up on this possession. Reeves drawing two, fires cross court to Randolph. And there's a nice finish at the rack. UCR showed a double team, and Florida A&M doing well to pass out of it.
Yeah, and MJ Randolph, good first step, and he knows how to get to the basket and finish.
Randolph had a rapid rise within the program. Back as a freshman, got limited opportunities, but made the most of them as J.P. Moorman's got his second triple. He's fired up as he heads back down the floor. UC Riverside, 5 of 9 from deep here to start.
That'll get it done.
Dragon Elkaz on the floor. He's defending Jameer Williams, who misses on the jumper. Williams in the ball game for the first time. That's a recipe for UC Riverside. Defense, rebounding, three-point shooting, and that's what they've done here to start.
Add great passing to that mix, and you have a good recipe for success for the Highlanders.
Looks like we're going to have a foul away for the ball on Florida A&M, and Jameer Williams, still just the second team foul against Florida A&M, so not close to the bonus here as we get closer towards halftime. Callum McCray checking back in, and Williams going to check off, and Dominguez Stevens going to enter for the first time for the Rattlers.
Very good on the defensive end is Dominguez.
He's a Seton Hall transfer. Didn't see much action last year with the Pirates, just 6 games. And stepping in front of the pass there is Murray with Randolph. And nice shot fake, gets the finish, and Randolph now up to 6 points.
He got two defenders up in the air, waited for him to pass, and then with the layup for Randolph.
Here's McCray. Cameron made the cut, didn't find him, but now he'll hit Elkaz. He's a bit short. Dragon Elkaz has been very good at home this season with 23 points in the previous 2 home games. And now Randolph heating up. He's made his last 3 from the floor.
They come in spurts with Randolph. Once he gets started, he doesn't stop.
back to a single-digit game, 27-18. McCray backing down Stamps. The help defense comes in, and a stolen ball for Bryce Morang. He's got a couple steals now as Randolph looking to heat up. Flynn Cameron matched up with him.
Highlanders already with 8 turnovers on the game.
Randolph bouncing his way inside, finishes on the reverse. Dazzling display from MJ Randolph, who has scored 8 straight points for the Rattlers.
With initials like MJ, you better be good. And he is.
Out of Pensacola, Florida, Pullen cannot answer. It's a 6-0 run for FAMU. Stamps wide open. Big clank, but an offensive rebound. Stevens open for 3. That's good. A 9-0 run for Florida A&M, and they are within 4, and J.P. Mormon turns it over at the other end as he stepped over the baseline trying to inbound the basketball, and that'll take us to a timeout on the floor. The Rattlers with a 9-0 run to pull within 4 here late in the first half. Play in the first half, and Florida A&M putting together a 9-0 run. MJ Randolph now up to 10 points. He's made his last 4 from the floor. What are you seeing here? Is this a little more Florida A&M's offense, or UC Riverside's defense slacking a little bit here?
No, I think you cannot keep a good offense down. Got great defense from the Highlanders, but the shooters are starting to get it going. MJ Randolph, as you mentioned, who does much more than just shooting for Florida A&M.
That one just rims out on him. As UC Riverside has been plagued by turnovers on this end of the floor. They've committed 9 turnovers. Florida A&M has not committed a single one. McCray, now Tattersall, and he's well off the mark. Tattersall, Pickett, and Matting all checking back in as Reeves steps into a 3. And there's a rebound for Tattersall. And foul, looks like it's going to go against Morang here. No. Yes, it is going to be called against FAMU, sorry. UC Riverside will have it, and Florida A&M will look to press here.
Highlanders need a bucket.
It was a 27-14 lead for UC Riverside. They've now gone more than 3 minutes without any points. Zion Pullen's been their best offensive player so far. Picks up his dribble and forced to give it back out for Pickett. Head of steam into the lane. Tattersall wide open. Mm. And he has just not been able to dial in the stroke here in the first half.
Highlanders needed that shot right there.
And Tattersall's gotten some good looks. And his last 2 have been well off. Here's Reeves. That one rattles home, and it's a 1-point ball game.
Rattlers have a lot of experience against really good teams, and it's showing here.
Cameron Reeves, grandson of head coach Robert McCollum. Big triple there, and it's a 12-0 run for the Rattlers. It's going to be a foul here against FAMU. And we'll stay with UC Riverside. Both teams at just four team fouls as we're inside a minute to play in the first. TJ Jones going to check back in for Meringue.
Jones with those long limbs can really get into the passing lanes and get in the shooter's face.
And Bryce Meringue did just pick up his third foul. Pulling back to McCray. Florida A&M trying to speed up UC Riverside here. They still have 10 on the shot clock. Elkaz back in the ball game. Matting flying in, gets a deflection, and McCray with the offensive rebound.
Slow it down.
Pullen gets his own miss. They can effectively hold for the final shot here. About a second differential between shot and game clock. UC Riverside scoreless in the last 5 minutes. Pickett wide open. Tipped around. Elkaz with a second left. And that'll do it for the first half. A 12-0 run for Florida A&M to close it. And what was once a 13-point lead for UC Riverside is just a one-point ball game at the half. It's the Highlanders and the Rattlers here on Black Friday afternoon. We'll be back here with more at halftime. We've got highlights. earlier in the week. But Baylor has been very good. They just beat Michigan State earlier today. Purdue has been strong as well. So at the top, teams still performing well here in the AP Top 10 here in the first month of the season. We'll step aside. More to come here from the SRC Arena at the half. UC Riverside leading. UC Riverside holding on to a one-point lead over Florida A&M, 27-26 at the break. Happy Thanksgiving to you all. Nick Cope alongside Stephen Douglas here courtside. Great to started finding their stroke there over the final 5 minutes as you take a look at the highlights. MJ Randolph up to 10 points. He made 5 out of his last 6 shots and has 10 points to lead all scorers. On the other side for UC Riverside, Zion Pullen with 9 points. They were at 1.5 of 8 from 3, but they are just 1 for their last 6 are the Highlanders. And you see when the threes are falling, they built the lead. And Florida A&M, I think, started to say, okay, we're going to let you take those here. We're gonna buckle down the paint, and we don't think you're going to be able to shoot like that for the entire 40 minutes.
As long as they're taking open threes, I think that's the key. As long as it's an open shot, let it. Fire away.
Now UC Riverside with 7 different scores in the game, but the only one above 3 points, only 2 players. J.P. Mormon had 6, Zion Pullen with 9. You have Callum McCray with 8 rebounds. Pullen pulled down 6 rebounds in that first half. So they do have the edge on the glass, 26-15. Now the one thing you can control, even if the threes aren't falling and you're taking good shots, is the turnovers. 0 for Florida A&M and 9 for UC Riverside. It's a Riverside team that haven't really had too much of a turnover bug this season. 9 is a high number for them.
Yeah, it is, and that could be a stat that determines the final score in this ball game. Highlanders got to be careful, and especially on transition, hold on to that ball.
Yeah, 9 turnovers turning into 10 points at the other end for Florida A&M. We'll take a break, and when we come back, second half action from the Inland Empire. UCR with a massive edge on rebounding. I think that one at the bottom, Steven, is the most interesting to me. Not a single free throw attempted. And these are teams at times this season, we've seen them get to the line 20-plus times.
Yeah, absolutely. Defense is stout. The offensive players have not been able to dribble, drive, penetrate. And that's where you pick up a lot of those fouls underneath the basket. We'll see how things change here and develop in the second half.
UC Riverside will have the basketball to begin the second half. Highlanders trying to get to 5-2 on the season and improve to 3-0 on their home floor. Well, Florida A&M looking to get their first win against a Division I program this season. Their lone win coming against Division II Lemoyne Owen College, based out of Memphis, as we are underway here in the second half. McCray, little shot fake and finish with the left hand for the big man from New Zealand. And McCray, 4 points to go along with a game-high 8 rebounds.
I like it. Get it inside of the big man. Get some of those easier high-percentage shots.
It's now 12 points in the paint for both teams. Reeves with 5 points in the first half. And McCray gathers the rebound. Now Cameron into the front court, dumping it off for Pullen, and we've got a foul away from the ball. It's going to go against DJ Jones, battling with J.P. Mormon underneath. Not a lot of fouls called in the first half either. Four for either side. However, Meringue, who is starting the second half, he's got three of them for FAMU. UC Riverside, that bucket for McCray, stopped a dry spell of over 5 minutes, extending back to the first half as Mormon misses.
Mormon had to change his shot a little bit with the defender right in his face.
And the jumper from Meringue is good. One of two players to start all 20 games last season for Florida A&M, and after missing the first three games, he's been pretty productive here so far this week. Cameron, McCray, the tip in. Four quick points here in the second half for Callum McCray.
So nice for the offense, having a seven-footer underneath, cleaning up on the boards. Good defense from Pickett.
And Pickett knocks it away, three on two here. And Pullen had it taken off by Randolph. What an athletic play. And on the other end, Reeves can't quite get the bounce. Boy, what a block from MJ Randolph, the closing speed.
Yeah, very athletic play right there. He's a very determined player who was not going to let Pullen score.
McCray to the corner. Extra passing sets up Cameron, and he's fouled on the three. Jalen Spear just barely got a piece of him. Not a wood. Will put Flynn Cameron at the free throw line. Our first free throws of the ball game coming up.
Can't talk enough about the passing there from the Highlanders. Looked like McCray had something underneath. He dished it out, got another dish, and another pass finding Flynn Cameron.
Cameron knocked down the first bucket of the ball game, a three, and hadn't scored until that free throw right there. His fifth year of college basketball, his second year here in Riverside after spending three seasons at DePaul. Originally from Auckland, has played with New Zealand's youth national teams as well. And there's a very productive trip to the line.
That can get a shooter going right there. Three freebies.
Back to a six-point margin. UC Riverside led by as many as 13 points in the first half for a 12-0 run from FAMU. Closed it to a one-point game at the break. Here's Randolph. He's got tape binding his ring finger and his pinky finger on his left hand as Cameron pulls down the rebound.
That's his third
now
on the night.
Pullen wanting to push. Reeves stays with him. Mormon, deep three.
And you're open. Shoot it.
Baseline jumper for Meringue is looked like UC Riverside switched to his own defense that time down the floor on the defensive end.
It's been effective for the last two possessions, that zone defense.
McCray finding Cameron. Oh, back to McCray, who wasn't looking for it.
When you cut towards the basket, you've got to be aware of the ball and where it is. McCray put his head down there.
He was probably going to have a good look at a layup, too. DJ Jones coming off. And Legend Stamps, the Rancho Cucamonga native, checking back in. And UCR sticking with the zone defense here. Florida A&M has not shot the three well this afternoon, just 2 for 9, and the long-running bank shot from Spear won't go. Pickett gets tied up. That's going to be a foul going against Reeves. Say came across the arm there. More free throws for the Highlanders.
I like the aggressive play from Pickett there. He went 1-on-3, took on the defenders, and he'll shoot a couple freebies.
So here is Dominic Pickett, a graduate student. Former student manager turned walk-on, now scholarship. Here's a sixth-year player.
his leadership for the Highlanders cannot be understated.
And last year he was named the best hustle player in the Big West. Second player from UC Riverside to ever earn that award. Christian Soto also won it back in 2008. 2-for-2 trip for Dominic Pickett. And UC Riverside back up by 8. Randolph able to drop it right over Callum McCray.
That's the way to beat the zone right there.
MJ Randolph leading all scorers with 12 points. McCray. Down to 10 to shoot. Pick and roll. McCray draws a double and can't quite finish. That was a great little move to set himself up. Left it short off the front of the rim. Randolph.
Twelfth rebound for McCray.
4 points from a double-double. And Matting has it blocked right at the rack. And it's knocked out of bounds by Randolph. Takes us to a timeout on the floor. UC Riverside with a 6-point lead, 15:07 to play in the second half here on ESPN. Line here at the start of the second half, and they've got a 36-30 lead on Florida A&M. Both teams shooting under 40%. But for UC Riverside, they've rebounded the basketball well. 35-19, the rebounding edge for the Highlanders.
That's probably made up for the turnover advantage that Florida A&M has at this point. 10-1.
At 10, that's quite a big ratio to one side, but credit to Florida A&M, way down on their season average of 15 per game, pulling the triple. Now UC Riverside had missed their last 7 threes. Pulling gets that one to fall, and he's in double figures with 12.
This is the time you want to pull away from the competition in this game, if at all possible.
Highlanders sticking with the zone defense here, 3-by-2, and Reeves short on the elbow jumper. Pulling gets into the middle, walks it back out.
Good decision.
Littles was defending him back in the ball game. Reset here from Pullen. Down the left side of the lane. Tough shot. McCray got a tip. Matting tipped it over to Pullen in the corner.
Reset.
The long arms there of Daniel Matting. He goes 6'9". Pickett, hesitation, looking for somewhere to dump it off to. That's going to be a blocking foul. Reeves hoping that he would earn a charge there. A bit slow to get up and will be helped onto his feet as we take another look. And it did look like he was leaning into the contact there.
Looked like Pickett could have taken that to the rack. He's so unselfish, always looking for the extra pass is Dominic Pickett.
Highlanders with 8 assists on 14 made baskets tonight as Quinton Ford back in the ballgame. Matting the triple, and he has now missed 9 in a row from deep going back a couple games, but another offensive rebound. Ford's going to get it back out to Pickett. It's now 9 offensive boards for the Highlanders. And we got an offensive foul. Pickett setting an illegal screen there. So it'll go to Florida A&M, trailing by 9.
Like to see a defensive stop right here for the Highlanders, try to get this ball back in a double-digit lead.
There's Jalen Spear, just checked back in. Sophomore out of Gainesville, Florida. He's an all-state level player in high school. Put up 12 points per game as a freshman last year.
See the zone defense really disrupting the offense for Florida A&M.
And Moran can't hit the elbow jumper. He's just 2 of 9 shooting this afternoon.
Highlanders have been daring him to shoot jump shots this entire game.
Pullen, and another offensive foul on a screen. Looks like that one will go against Quinton Ford, I think. Well, it should be McCray. The official didn't put up a 2-5. And now confirmation is Callum McCray. So back-to-back illegal screens for UC Riverside. Turning it over back to FAMU. MJ Randolph with 10 in the first half, just 2 so far here in half number 2. Highlanders zone defense has stepped up. And FAMU just 2 of 10 shooting here in the second half. Rang finding Littles, pulls the trigger. Battle for the rebound, won by Morang. Wide open 3 for Spear. Ball knocked around off the baseline, and it's off the knee of Morang and will go to the Highlanders.
Highlanders need to do a little bit better job of boxing out Morang on that possession. Luckily, the ball out of bounds on Morang.
And 2 good looks there for Florida A&M, but come up empty as Dominguez Stevens checks in for Littles. Zion Pullen with 12 points to go along with 7 rebounds and 2 assists. Quinton Ford hasn't played a ton tonight. And just gets that ball to Martinez, who's trying to get himself free. And it's going to be a foul against Florida A&M. The baseline inbound coming for the Highlanders. And FAMU, who had just 4 fouls in the first half, they're already up to 5 here in the second half. Jalen Martinez in for McCray, setting the screen for Pullen. Jalen Spear all over him, and Pullen gonna back it out. Now Mormon setting a screen. And another illegal screen as he shoved his backside into Jalen Spear. That is 3 consecutive illegal screens set by the Highlanders. It takes us to a timeout on the floor. UC River. University Riverside hanging on here to a 39-30 lead. I say hanging on because neither team has scored for the last 3 minutes or so. Three consecutive illegal screens set by UC Riverside, but fortunately for the Highlanders, unfortunately for the Rattlers, they've not been able to take advantage.
Yeah, I had mentioned that this was the time that the Highlanders needed to separate themselves, but haven't been able to do so with those illegal screens.
Awkward take to the basket by MJ Randolph, who I think was anticipating some contact, and UCR just kind of let him go. And on the other end, Quinton Ford finishes the fast break.
Nice take there from Q.
Now the lead back to double digits for UC Riverside. FAMU now scoreless over the last 4.5 minutes. Just 2 of 13 shooting here in the second half. This zone defense from the Highlanders has caused them fits, and the open threes have not gone down.
Yeah, if they hit a couple of those threes, we're talking about a different scenario here.
Pullen with an open three, steps right into it and drills it. Zion Pullen leading all scorers with 15 points.
Nice smooth stroke on the three ball there from Zion Pullen.
Randolph hesitates and out of bounds. It'll stay with Florida A&M.
Randolph just went up against most of the Highlanders' defense there with no fear. Unsuccessfully, of course, but I like his attack. I like his drive.
Now UC Riverside now with its largest lead of the ball game. There's just 7 to shoot here for FAMU. Stevens, 3 to shoot. Spear, no one sees the shot clock. James does, but he ran out of time. DJ Jones unable to get it off in time, and that's just the second turnover against FAMU. UC Riverside will have it.
A little bit of a communication breakdown there. Nobody told or counted down.
They didn't hear anybody from the bench for the Rattlers either. A little bit of a press trap here, and it's pulling along the baseline. And now back out to Cameron. He'll step into the three.
Nice look. Didn't go this time.
Stevens, the corner three, rims out on him. Back and forth we go here, midway through the second half. Pull into the corner. Cameron hoists another. That one's good. Nothing but net. And UC Riverside has opened up a 17-point lead. They have outscored Florida A&M 20-4 since halftime. And timeout called here by Robert McCullum. Take us to a timeout on the floor. UC Riverside, their largest lead of the ball game. 9:44 to play in the second half on ESPN. Florida A&M trying to find their shooting stroke here in the second half. They're just 2 for 15. We've seen UC Riverside go to a zone defense. FAMU has had open looks at three, but I wonder for the Highlanders and Mike Magpio, if they're content with that, they just don't want MJ Randolph to heat up like he did in the first half.
Yeah, Randolph, Spear, Jones, those are guys that can get inside and cause havoc for the defense. With this zone, I think it's kind of taken the Rattlers out of their offensive game.
Rattlers just 2 of 14 from distance in the ball game, and just 4 points so far in the second half. Make it 6 as Bryce Murray knocks down the baseline jumper. He's up to 6 points, and that stops a dry spell that was extending over 6 minutes for Florida A&M.
Highlanders will take that shot, though, every time down for the Rattlers.
Flynn Cameron kicking it out. Mormon trying to no-look pass, got deflected, still made its way to 4, and a deep 3 from Pickett. And that is saved off the leg of Randolph. Flynn Cameron with the hustle play. And a fresh 20 seconds here for UC Riverside.
Smart.
And Callum McCray got to check back in here for Martinez.
Smart play by Flynn Cameron. And then McCray comes in with his 12 rebounds. His career high is 14.
Hands it off here for Pickett. Mormon catch and shoot 3. Cameron, another offensive rebound. Mormon to the hole, and he's fouled. And the offensive rebounds really starting to pile up here in the second half. You got 11 for the ball game. UC Riverside has a 45-21 edge on the glass, more than doubling up the Rattlers. Here's JP Mormon, 5 of 7 at the line this season. Make it 5 of 8 with that miss. So one thing UC Riverside definitely wants to improve upon is this season continues. They're the worst team in the Big West when it comes to free throw shooting, under 60%.
Something they definitely need to work on, especially once they get into conference.
1 for 2 trip for J.P. Mormon. He's up to 7 points now. Still Zion Pullen, the only man in double figures with UC Riverside, and he's getting a breather on the bench currently. Jones handing it off for Randolph, draws a double team. UC Riverside back at a man defense as Meringue on the pull up, and he's had that mid-range jumper. Plenty of opportunities today, and he's knocked down back-to-back buckets.
Yeah, as I said earlier, though, Highlanders will take that shot every time.
Mormon, extra pass, Cameron, too strong, and Meringue has the rebound. That time, Florida A&M trying to speed up UC Riverside. Meringue, 3 straight buckets.
All right, I'm not going to say they're going to be happy with him taking that shot anymore if he keeps knocking it down. Get a hand in his face.
Well, he's on fire now, and now he steps in front of the passing lane, and this is what was happening in the first half when Florida A&M made their run. Reeves can't hit the 3, but Meringue the offensive rebound, forcing it up against McCray, who has the block. 1-on-2 here for Quentin Ford, and he's wisely going to slow it up.
Nice play by Ford just to slow the tempo down. Get under control, get in the set offense.
Riverside still with a 12-point lead. Mormon had it knocked free, fires to the corner. Ford's triple is good.
What a play by Mormon to get that ball back and then find Quentin Ford in the corner.
Highlanders 4 of 10 from deep in the second half. Randolph drawing all kinds of attention. Now it's Spear, and he is fouled. And Jalen Spear drawing contact from Flynn Cameron, takes to a timeout on the floor. UC Riverside still leading by 15 with 6:46 to play on ESPN. SRC Arena here on the campus of UC Riverside. 15-point lead for the Highlanders. This was a one-point ball game at halftime thanks to a 12-0 run at the end of the first half. MJ Randolph, a big part of that for FAMU. Zion Pullen has had a great second half. He leads all scorers with 15 points. And UC Riverside, they're not at the point where they can cruise just yet with 6:46 to play. They got to feel like they're in a good spot right here.
Yeah, started hitting some of those three-pointers again. Great on the offensive and defensive glass. And looking to put this one away, although Spear adds another point there for FAMU.
Highlanders were trying to bring J.P. Mormon into the game, but they did not get him to the bench in time. Now it looks like they're just going to bring him all the way back down. Now one more free throw for Jalen Spear. Sophomore, he had 19 points and 4 3-pointers against Miami last Saturday. And a 2-for-2 trip there. Back to a 13-point ball game. UC Riverside is led by as many as 17. And McCray couldn't handle the pass. Another turnover for UCR. 14 of them now. And they force one at the other end, though. Dominic Pickett deflecting the pass from MJ Randolph.
Slow it down if you're the Highlanders. Don't get into their game. Another turnover.
Highlanders have been forcing passes last few times down the floor. Spear an open three. That one rims out. And the Rattlers appear a bit snake bit when it comes to three-point land.
Yeah, what are they, 2-for-16 now? Jalen Spear is usually a little bit better from three land than he's been today.
And most of them have been good looks.
Yes, yeah, just not falling.
McCray thundering inside, great spin move. McCray now 8 points to go along with those season-high 12 rebounds. Randolph trying to get free, but Ford staying right with them. And now into the game, Chase Bars, his first action this afternoon, knocks down his first shot. Bars is a transfer from Western Michigan, played in 47 games across two seasons for the Broncos. He's a Florida guy originally from the Tampa area and commits a foul here against Zion Pullen. And that will put UC Riverside in the bonus. And a 1-1 situation now for Zion Pullen. Now J.P. Mormon will check back in for four. But for Pullen, been a very efficient game. 15 points on 6 of 12 shooting. He's 3 of 4 from beyond the arc and hitting the glass. He's the second leading rebounder on the team with 8 of them.
Also got 4 dimes to go along with his 16 points now and 8 rebounds.
Coming into today, he had gone to the line 34 times this season, the second most in the conference behind Tony Rosak of San Diego. 2-for-2 trip there, that's a good sign for UC Riverside. They've only missed one free throw today and a missed finish there. Chase Bars, that pass was a little bit high and behind him and couldn't finish.
Mismatch underneath, and they double-team McCray.
FAMU still trying to chase the ball here and speed up the Highlanders. Pickett, the three. FAMU needs buckets now, 4.5 to play. Randolph, little scoop shot past the 7-footer.
Randolph received that ball in the post as though he's a 7-footer, but maybe that's where they need to find their offense with Randolph. Get him underneath.
His first bucket since the early moments of the second half. Dragon Elcats. He hasn't been able to convert on his chances from deep. Spear, long two, rims off. And McCray pulls down a rebound. I believe that's number 14 now, so he's matched a career high in that department. In inside, 4 minutes to play. UC Riverside still with double-digit edge, but that's a bad pass from Callum McCray trying to bowl it to the low block. But FAMU still cannot find a three-point attempt. As a team, they are now one for their last 12. And a timeout will be called here by UC Riverside. We'll step aside for the final time this afternoon, 55-42, UC Riverside in control. UC Riverside 3:24 away from going 3-0 on their home floor this season. And Florida A&M needing to find some offense here in a hurry. They've been unable to find their three-point shot in the second half. 0-for-10 from deep. And we're talking about it. These are good looks. I feel like as a coach, you know, these are catch-and-shoot rhythm three-pointers, and they just can't get them to fall.
Yeah, they're the type of shots that coach is going to tell you every time, take that shot. You're open. Those are going to fall. They just haven't fallen today for the Rattlers.
For the game, they are at 12%. For the season, though, they're at about 33%, so they're capable. It just hasn't fallen, and three from Flynn Cameron off the mark. Turnaround jumper from Randolph, and McCray has a new career high now. That was rebound number 16.
He's had a very good game.
What the Highlanders have done now in terms of defending the three-point line as they turn it over for the 17th time, but they held UTEP to 1 of 24 from deep on Monday. And today, they have held Florida A&M 2 of 17 in total. So by my quick math, that is 3 for 41 this week and holding opponents to a very low percentage from beyond the arc.
Good perimeter defense, although there has been some open looks that the Rattlers could have hit in this game.
This is turned back over to the Highlanders. J.P. Mormon coming back on here. 2:38 to play. And Jameer Williams will enter. Now, Florida A&M mentioned early on. In game number 5, they have already played in all 4 time zones. And they've got a very tough non-conference schedule. They've already played Miami. They're also going to play Illinois and Arizona State as Callum McCray gets himself a double-double, 10 points to go along with 16 rebounds.
Nice dime from Dominic Pickett on that one.
Up and under move, the finish from Jalen Spear. FAMU going to come out west one more time. They're going to play Santa Clara and UC Santa Barbara before they take on ASU next month.
Good play, partner.
Another errant pass from the Highlanders.
I thought that pass was to us.
Two minutes to go. Meringue is in double figures to go along with Randolph. You see the double team come in. You see Riverside is just taking no chances with him.
Harmon's had a good game quietly. 7 points, has his fourth rebound. He's also got two assists.
You see Riverside in no hurry here. And they're gonna give it back out to Pullen. Still got 15 on the shot clock here. And this one deflected out of bounds.
Highlanders, unselfish as always, trying to find the extra pass, and 12 seconds still on the shot clock.
Now, Pullen's been great today, 17 points, and a very efficient 6 of 12 from the floor. Cameron has to get it up with the shot clock winding down and drills it. A rainbow three-pointer from about 35 feet for Flynn Cameron. Might be the exclamation point on this one. Take another look.
Zion Pullen, dribble penetration, finds his man wide open but deep. And he knocks it down with time expiring from the shot clock.
Flynn Cameron's in double figures now with 12 points. Three triples. Quick three on the other end. Gets a friendly bounce for Jalen Spear. Cameron trapped. And Mormon fakes the pass. He'll take it into the front court. UCR just going to let the clock run out here before they have to take a shot. Pullen working on his handles. McCray the double-double. Career high 16 rebounds to go along with 10 points.
Four.
Down to three to shoot here. Mormon shot faking. A little finger roll. And a shot clock violation. That long scooping motion, and Mormon didn't get it off in time. Shot clock off here. Florida A&M going to fall to 1-4 this season. And again, it's been a very difficult schedule for the Rattlers. A lot of games away from home. There's a tough shot put in by Jalen Spear. A couple buckets here late. He's in double figures now. So, final score will look a little more respectable. Florida A&M was held to just 4 points about 10.5 minutes into the second half. And UC Riverside in control, and they improved a 5-2 on the season. Highlanders